the latest in skill acquisition and performance research from PerceptionAction.com. What are the implications for skill acquisition and coaching if we accept that performers are complex adaptive systems? In a new opinion article posted on Sports Medicine, Pohl and colleagues consider this interesting question. They emphasize that athletes and teams are co-adaptive and develop functional synergies within their environment. Under this view, the key to performing at a high level is not being able to repeat the one optimal technique, but rather the diversity of skill. To quote the authors, "Contrary to common assumption, the fittest are not necessarily the strongest nor the fastest, but the most diverse. Developing strength or velocity is just a means to gain diversity potential, particularly in sports like football, where the stability and reproducibility of game situations is rare. Teams and players continuously deal with a highly unstable, non-cooperative environment. In such contexts, survival, in the tournament, championship, or league, is defined by positive competition results, which are better achieved through a higher diversity potential." There's lots of great implications for training here, so definitely check it out. An increasingly popular way to increase diversity in sports like soccer is the use of small-sided games. In an article published in Frontiers in Psychology, Nunes and colleagues examined how different versions of this influence a variety of different performance variables. In particular, the authors distinguish situations of numerical inferiority, less players on your side like playing 3-on-4, versus superiority, more players on your side like playing 4-on-3. It was found that these different varieties of small-sided play produce different outcomes. For example, high inferiority situations resulted in greater physical demands, like covering more distance running, while low inferiority conditions involved more tactical decisions. This is great information for coaches to use in practice design to achieve different training outcomes. Finally today, I wanted to mention a couple more journal special issues, one that's just completed and one that will soon open for submission. In Frontiers in Psychology, a new complete issue on the topic of radical embodied cognitive science. For those that haven't heard this term before, it is basically an approach to understanding the human brain that rejects the idea that our brain is a passive computer like the one sitting on your desk. It instead focuses on the relationship between the brain, body, and the environment. The other one, which will eventually appear in Human Movement Science, focuses on individual differences in motor learning. From the email I received about it, quote, "Despite the success we've had at identifying the characteristics of expertise and the necessary conditions for its achievement, relatively little attention has been focused on describing the variety of initial starting points from which, and the pathways through which, individuals develop into elite performers. This special issue is not focused on expertise per se, but on the study of how individual difference characteristics moderate or mediate the effects of the experimental manipulations commonly used to enhance motor learning," end quote. Deadline is December 1st, 2020. That's the latest from the world of skill acquisition. Find the links to the articles I mentioned today on my blog page and learn much more by subscribing to the Perception in Action podcast at perceptionaction.com. Have a great day and keep them coupled.